Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today we are going to show you how to search for those special characters in Microsoft Excel. So here I have a spreadsheet, and in column A, I have some entries that have special characters and some that do not. So what I want to do is I want to be able to return a false for anything that has a non-alphanumeric character. And so I can see right here that I have this @, a non-alphanumeric character. So this is going to return with a false because this is not a valid employee ID. However, this one down here only has letters and numbers. So I want that to return true. Also, we will have some additional training options for you at the end of this video. So stick around for that. So how do I go about doing this? Well, in order to do that, we actually need to use three different functions. The first function we need to use is the search function. And then the second function we need to use is the isNumber function. And then the third we are going to use is the sumProduct function. But let's start off with the first one I mentioned, the search function. So I'm going to type equals search with a left parenthesis. And my first argument inside my search function is going to be find text. Now, what text am I looking for? Well, if you go out on our blog, the link to that is in the description below, and you go to step one of the first method, you can copy and paste what I'm about to paste here. So I'm going to press Control V on my keyboard, and I'm going to paste this series of non-alphanumeric characters that I want to be searching for. And if you notice, these non-alphanumeric characters are enclosed in curly brackets. And that curly bracket can be found on your keyboard above the square bracket. And it's usually next to the letter P. So if I hold down Shift and the left square bracket, I'll get the left curly bracket. And if I hold down Shift and the right square bracket, I'll get the right curly bracket. So after I've enclosed all of these, then I want to type a comma. And then next I will be asked for the within text. Now the within text is, where am I searching for these characters? So the find text is the characters I'm looking for, and the within text is the string I am searching for those characters. So in our case, that's going to be in A2. So I'm going to click on A2, close my parentheses for the search function, and then hit enter. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel, and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos. And you can see that I get this whole string of values across all of my columns. And if I count up all these values, it's going to be the same number of characters that I'm looking for. So from B to P is 15 columns, and I have 15 characters that I'm looking for. And I can see right here where it says 7, what has happened here is in the 7th place, Excel has found my 10th character that I listed because K is my 10th column. So if I look up here, my 10th character is the @. So it found my 10th character in the 7th position of my search string. So now if I hover my mouse down here around this box on the bottom right-hand corner and I click and drag to the bottom, I can copy those formulas all the way to the bottom of my data set. So if I click back in B1, I can see I'm looking at A2. But if I click in B3, I can see that I'm looking at A3, and so on all the way down. So right now, this looks a little messy. I'm sure you don't want this saying value, value, value all the way across. So if I click in B2, and I click in between the equal sign and my search function, I'm going to put the function isNumber with a left parenthesis. And then I'm going to go to the very end of my search function and put a right parenthesis and hit enter. Now, instead of all these values, I'm getting false, but over here in K, I'm getting true. So this is a little bit more readable, but it's still not optimal because I really don't want my data spreading across all of these columns. So there's one more function we can use so that we get a much more desired result. But before we use our final function, in between the equal sign and the is number, I want to put two minus signs. And what that's going to do is it is going to take away the word true and false and return a one for true and a zero for false. So if I press enter, I can now see that my true value is being represented with a one. And hopefully now you can see why I did that, because I'm going to use one more function called SUMPRODUCT. And in order to use SUMPRODUCT, I need to be summing up numbers and not words. So if I click back in B2 and click in between the equal sign and the first minus sign, then I'm going to type SUMPRODUCT with a left parenthesis. And then I'm going to go to the very end of our long series of functions and type a right parenthesis and press enter. So now I'm being returned with a one if any of those characters are found within the string in column A. So you might like a one. This might be good enough for you to stop here for whatever needs you have. So you could see how you could put an if statement in here that if this whole result is greater than zero, then you can type a certain word. Or if not, you can type another word. So you could use the if statement here. But something else you could do if you want to turn the ones and the zeros back to true or false, is if I click back in B2, and at the very end, I'm just going to type equals zero. So basically, if this entire sum product equals zero, there are no special characters. But if it equals anything that's not zero, there are special characters. So now if I hit enter, I'm returned with the word false instead of being returned with a one. So again, if I click and hold the bottom right of my cell right here and drag to the bottom, I can copy the formula all the way down. And I can now see that I'm being returned with a false anytime one of these characters in my string show up. And I'm being returned with a true whenever my list of characters is not found. So it seems a little backwards, but it's not, because I really do want to be returned with a true when I have a valid employee ID in there. And I'm assuming that my employee IDs cannot have the string of characters. So let's say I went to F3 right here and I put an asterisk at the end. I'm still being returned with a true. But if I click in B3 and I type a comma here and in double quotes, I put an asterisk and hit enter. Now I'm being returned with a false. So I just wanted to show you that you can add anything you want to this string of characters to search for. Now, if you prefer to use VBA code, or if you would like to see an option for how you can do this in Power Query, you can go to our blog and we have given you a sample function that you can copy into VBA. And we've also given you step-by-step instructions for how to use this in Power Query. So I will put the link to our blog entry in the description below on YouTube. If you have any questions or comments, please type them below and we'll get back to you. Thanks for watching and see you again next time. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.